Hi, this is David McCann for WebTNG. This video is for power users. In it, I'm looking at a technique for locking down the WordPress admin, and I'm looking at it as experimental or a work in progress. Now, what am I talking about? Well, WordPress site owners are continuously fighting to keep hackers out of the site admin. There are brute force attacks on the WP login page. There's remote code execution due to zero-day plugin vulnerabilities and hacker toolkits that try to access files by cycling through lists of known vulnerabilities. These types of attacks have to be blocked. I've discovered that it's fairly common for people to have two or even three security plugins active on their site. But suppose there was a technique that, at least for some sites, could stop many of the common types of attacks in their tracks. And that's what we're looking at here. I've been on the lookout for site lockdown hardening techniques for new security plugins, and it's not very often that I come across something I haven't tried yet. But I recently was reading the documentation for Phantom WP, and something there caught my eye. Phantom WP is a new project from Ovidiu Mahistu that provides a platform for using WordPress for the back end of your site and Astro for the front end of the site. This is the website for Phantom WP. Okay, now one of the common advantages cited for headless WordPress configurations is that they're more secure because visitors are hitting a front end that isn't even part of the WordPress site. They never actually get to the WordPress site. And Phantom WP has an interesting way of locking down the WordPress site. And it's in this section here. And basically what it does is that you add a web browser extension, you configure it to send a custom HTTP request header when you visit your website that you're an administrator of, and you add to Cloudflare or your Nginx config or your htaccess file some directives that block anyone from accessing the site who doesn't have that HTTP request header. For Phantom WP, you can block your entire site. But obviously for us, for me, I want visitors to be able to read the blog articles and whatnot on WebTNG and my other sites. So I only want to block access to the admin and to the WP login page. So I think I found a way to adapt this technique from Phantom WP in a more general way. Before we leave the Phantom WP website, let me just show you here. These are the setup steps for Phantom WP. The UI, there's a place in the UI where you can generate your secret key for your HTTP request header. Then you install a browser extension here, and I'll show you how you configure that. Okay, and then here are instructions for the Phantom WP project on how you would set this up for Cloudflare. And Cloudflare has the advantage of hackers aren't even getting to your website, so that's a nice advantage of Cloudflare. But it also has instructions for Nginx and for htaccess. What I've done is I installed this extension, browser extension, okay? And, you know, I'm not using the request header name that Phantom WP is or their secret keys or anything. What I did is just called mine XWeb Express Mode as kind of a generic vanilla something that people might not attract attention. And then I gave it this as the value, full cache 1024. There's an option here for filter. And I added the request domain filter, and that gave us this addition to the UI here where I added the domain name in. And then the last thing I did here is there is a checkbox to always stay enabled, and I checked that. I've added my request header. So the next thing I want to do is I want to go to my website. Okay, this is Brave, and I'm logged in. You know, I'm the admin on the site. Let's go look at the plugins installed. You'll notice that I have PatchStack Security installed. PatchStack is a good security plugin, but it doesn't block people from the login page. Instead, it has some brute force detection where after X number of failed attempts, it will block the visitor. This is the site in Brave, but now this is that same site in Firefox. So I don't have the browser extension here, right? And if I go to the login form, see, it lets me go to the login form. I want to block that off. So I've opened the htaccess file for this site. In this case, I'm using xCloud, and I'm going to add in some htaccess rules here at the top. All right, and so what this is, you know, it turns on the rewrite engine. The first two rules are checking to see if, are you trying to go to the WP login or the WP admin? Okay, and NC means that it's not case sensitive. And then the third condition is checking for our HTTP request header, X web express mode, and that's the value. If you're going to these two and you don't have this, then you get a 403 forbidden. That's kind of basically what it does. So let's save this. Now let's go to Firefox. And let's go to the login form. Aha, we get the 403 forbidden, so it's blocked. That's what we want. The user is able to read the articles. And let's see if we can post a comment. So I'll put in name and email. And click post comment. And the comment was saved. Okay, so the front end is working, but they're not able to go to the login form. That's what we want. Now, let's see if it's working here for the logged in user. Right, I can still get around. There's my comment. Let's go to the home page, right? So everything still works fine for the admin because I have this request header. All right, so that's the technique in a nutshell. Now, using IP addresses for whitelist or blacklist isn't new. You could, instead of having a security header, this custom security header, instead of that, you could add in a rewrite condition with your IP address, so that the rules wouldn't get triggered if it was your IP address. For that to work, though, your IP address can't change. If I restart my router, I might get a different IP address. If I'm using my tablet, which uses mobile data, I would have a different IP address. If I'm traveling, and the nice thing about this request header is once it's in there, I don't have to go and edit the htaccess file. I can just install that browser extension and configure it. Whereas if I'm using an IP address and I'm traveling, then I would have to go in and modify this file. So I do have a companion article that goes with this video on the WebTNG website, and I have an example there of using an IP address. And when I tested this on a production site, lo and behold, I found that Blog Vault didn't work because this was blocking the IP addresses, was blocking Blog Vault. And so I had to whitelist the Blog Vault IP addresses, and I put that example on the website as well. Now, this is why I'm saying that it's kind of a power user thing. If something went wrong, you'd need to have FTP or SSH to go in to the site to undo what you had added. If there's a problem with a plugin or something not working, you're going to need to do some debugging and troubleshooting. So that's why I'm saying it's a power user technique. As I mentioned, I'm using Patch Stack here, and you can see that Patch Stack has added a number of rules and configuration to the htaccess file. So I don't think I need to do more than this, but there are certainly a lot of lockdown options that can be added. There's a lot of information available online in different articles and videos. But also, if you're interested in these types of techniques, Jeff Starr has a book called htaccess Made Easy. He doesn't cover this exact scenario, but has a large number of examples available. There's a website here that shows the table of contents for the book, so you can see what the book covers. Some of the people who are watching this video are going to immediately understand what's happening and how it works. Some people watching the video will test it out, experiment and try it, and then understand how it works. But other people are going to look at this and go, whoa, this is a little too complex for me. And if you're one of those people, I recommend you skip this. If you're not comfortable testing it, then skip it. This isn't for every WordPress user. It isn't for every WordPress site. It's not something that you see as an option in any of the security plugins. They are only offering features which work for the majority that everyday users can implement without creating a lot of support requests, and that you can use on every site. Now, you probably wouldn't use this technique, for example, on a client site or on a site where you had multiple logged in users, like multiple authors or multiple admins, things like that. Now, if you're a power user and you try this out, I'd like to hear how it went for you. Was it not worth it? It was too much hassle? Or did you have to add some additional code as workarounds for plugins? If you did get it to work for Nginx or Cloudflare and you want to share your example, I'd be happy to add that to the companion article and give you credit. But I'm kind of excited about this because what it means is that in addition to my security plugins, my username password login, and two-factor authentication, I now have another security option in my toolkit. And this technique totally blocks out the WP login and the WP admin. So I hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.